In this video, I'm going to explain to you the advantages and disadvantages of collagen for penile girth augmentation. There is a large variety of fillers on the market. What are the differences between them? Why choose filler A over filler B? There are certain characteristics with each one of them, which I am explaining in my videos here on UroChannel. If you are thinking of girth enhancement for yourselves, it might be worth knowing what you are going into, because outcome of the procedure, longevity of the result, risks and possible side effects may differ between fillers. If you are new to UroChannel or haven't watched any of my videos lately, please check out the playlist I am going to link at the end. This video is one of many on penile enlargement. It is possible I have already covered your questions in a different one. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. In my last upload, I covered hyaluronic acid, which I think is the most versatile filler of them all, and the one that has the lowest complication rate. Collagen was the standard filler in the US for over two decades. It was approved by the FDA in 1981, and it was the only product commercially available in the US for 22 years. I think this is why many of you still remember collagen. Collagen is the main building block of the connective tissue in your body. It accounts for a third of the body's protein. Collagen is very important for proper function of the fiber skeleton of the penis. So using it as a filler is a good thing because it's all natural. In 2003, hyaluronic acid was approved by the FDA, and that kind of demarcated a turning point. Hyaluronic acid was a real advancement. However, collagen set a standard that every new filler introduced to the market is compared to. So, what is the main weakness of collagen? By the way, did you know that you can become a member of UroChannel? I just started memberships. Check out the perks and become a member today to support my work. Your membership helps to maintain the high quality of my content. Many hours of preparation go into each of my videos to bring you the most up-to-date scientific knowledge possible. The main weakness of collagen is that it breaks down quickly. Its effect mostly lasts for 2 to 6 months only. Collagen fillers are derived from different sources. There are products made from cow, pig, or human. Bovine and human collagen fillers both have that short-term efficacy of 2 to 6 months I just mentioned. Bovine collagen has some potential for allergic reactions, but this occurs rather infrequently and affects approximately 3% of patients. However, if it happens, the reaction is often severe. Therefore, allergy testing is recommended a few weeks before the injection. Allergic reactions are not a problem with human collagen filler. Porcine collagen filler is made from pig tendons. During manufacturing, they do some magical trick, so that its structure very much resembles human collagen, so allergic reactions are relatively rare. And in addition to that, porcine collagen filler has the longest period of action. It lasts for at least 6 months and up to 12 months. I'm going to introduce you to the other fillers as well in my other videos. For the time being, the ideal filler is yet to be discovered. Hyaluronic acid comes close, but what are we really looking for in the perfect product? It should be as biocompatible with the body as possible so that it doesn't cause any side effects. It should be stable and not be broken down by the body so that it keeps its volume. At the same time, it should remain pliable. It should be easy to administer and provide patient satisfaction. Here's the playlist on penile enlargement. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. Ich weiß, dass meine Videos auch viele Menschen in Deutschland erreichen. Anfangs war UroChannel zweisprachig, aber nach einer Weile erwies sich das als nachteilig. Daher habe ich deutsche Videos vor ein paar Jahren ausgelagert. Sie befinden sich nun auf meinem Kanal Urologie.